involved in offensive flow more.
They haven't done it in past games, and it's really hurt their
putting too much pressure on their backcourt men. And another thing, the front line's going to have to box out. If they box out, they could get that quick outlet, and they're off to the races. This team could run like the UCLA Bruins when they have a chance.
Thanks, Dan. Mike, what do you think the key to stopping the guards of Brighton, Pat Hamilton, Ron Cooper, and Ronnie Auburn?
The key to stopping those guys, which is most of Brighton's offensive power, is to stop their outside shooting. Because if you stop that, then you have a good chance of winning. The big men don't really get involved in the offense too much.
Thanks, Mike. We'll be back in a minute with the start of tonight's ball game. Eastridge Lancers. Number 20, Bob Tomei. Number 32, Eugene Neal. Number 10, Mike Massino. Number 12, Mark Vesey. And number 42, Tom Schleich. And for their... That's the jump. And now the starting lineups for the Almacenos Eastridge Lancers. Number 20, Bob Toma. Number 32, Eugene Neal. Number 10, Mike Massino. Number 12, Mark Vesey. And number 42, Tom Schleich. And for Clarence Mepham's Brighton Barons, we have number 44, Ron Albert. Number 22, Ron Cooper. Number 14, Pat Hamilton. And number 42, Steve Lindley. And number 40, Grant Foreman.
While Wolfie was reading the starting lineups, Brighton just had their first turnover of the game, and now it's Eastridge's ball.
You know, Dan, Brighton is trying to get revenge for January 6th loss to Eastridge, 59-58 in overtime.
Don, part of the reason I think Brighton lost that game, they were very flat and they took Eastridge too lightly. Brighton should blow these guys right off the court.
Neal with a shot, defensive rebound by Pat Hamilton. He brings it up court, 3-on-1. Pass up, shoot, miss, offensive, Pat Hamilton, he gets the point, Brighton leads 2-0.
What a ball player that Pat Hamilton is.
Shot by number 20, Bob Tomei, missed, defensive rebound. Cooper's got it, off balance shot, it's off the rim. Hamilton, offensive, rebound, puts it up, missed. Rebound by number 10, Mike Massino.
John, I think Eastridge, it would be stupid to try to run with this ball club. They're basically a slow-down team. I don't think they should try to run with Brighton. Brighton has too much team speed overall, and it might hurt them in the overall game.
Massino with a long-distance shot gets the first point for Eastridge. And it's 2-2 with 6:32 remaining in the first quarter. Pass off from Albert to Foreman. Foreman over to Cooper, out of bounds. Eastridge ball.
John, in order for Brighton to win tonight, they must crash the boards like they've been doing so far in the game.
Hamilton's got 2 offensive rebounds so far.
So far, John, Brighton looks very sloppy in this ball game. I'm not very impressed with them, but that's a nice steal.
Ball on number 10, Mike Massino. His first and the team first.
Massino is known for that set shot all around the county. He's not really a strong ball player, but he has a really nice set shot from 20 and on.
He had 18 points last game for Eastridge in the upset over Brighton. Albert, floor leader, pass off. Over to Lindley. Foreman's underneath. They're going to set it up again. Albert takes it to the middle.
The nice pass by Ronnie A. Granny wasn't looking for it.
Massino brings it all the way up court and gets his fourth point of the game as Eastridge takes the lead 4-2.
I think it's important to say Ronnie Albert is playing hurt today. He has a bad hand. He hurt it in a game, I believe.
Shot by Hamilton's off the mark. Mark Massino comes up with a rebound for the Lancers. Mark Vinci takes over the ball.
I think Eastridge's key on offense is to get it into Al Neal, like right there.
Right there, Eugene Neal with his first points of the ball game. It's now 6-2 Eastridge. Albert's getting pressured backcourt, and there's a foul on Massino, his second of the game.
Brighton's going to help out Ronnie A. When Ronnie A, he's being left all alone out there. For a point guard, you have to have another man on the side and then diagonal cut. very easy to beat this press Eastridge is throwing.
Foreman has it, pass over to Lindley. Lindley up court and spat it out of bounds by number 20, Bob Tomei. Brighton ball.
I think Brighton should have their backcourt men back there trying to break that press instead of having the two front men leave one guy back and have maybe Grant or Lindley at midcourt. Therefore, they'd break it a lot easier. They really look sloppy today, John.
Another deflection by Mike Messino, but it stays Brighton's ball. Brighton's leading scorer is Patrick Hamilton with 15.2 points per game. Cooper, over to Hamilton. Over to Ron Albert. Foreman's trying to set up the high post. Bad pass by Albert. Another turnover.
John, I think that hand is... I think that hand's really bothering Ron's game today. Just doesn't look sharp like he usually does.
The ball on Steve Lindley, his first of the game and the first for Brighton. Yes, Albert hurt his game in the Friday night loss to Fairport, and he didn't practice with the team on Monday.
I would say Ronnie A is the premier point in the County East. He's had a sensational year this season. I think all counties just right around the corner for him.
Shot by Tomey's off the mark. Defensive rebound by Albert. Brings up court. Good ball. Behind the back pass to Hamilton. How's Pat's going to set it up? Pass off to Cooper, who's averaging 14.0 points a game for the Barons.
In
the
nice pass.
Foreman puts off off-bound shot, and the defensive rebound by Eugene Neal of Eastridge. Long pass by Messino, and there's a foul on Steve Lindley for the Barons. His second of the game and second team foul for Brighton.
I am really shocked that Eastridge is running with Brighton. I think right now they're up 6-2, but in later stages of the game, I think this is going to hurt their ball club trying to run with this team.
Substitution for Brighton, number 24, Nomini Robinson, has come in for Grant Foreman. Mike Messino is at the line, shooting two.
That looks like a questionable call there on Steve Lindley. The ref said he got him with his body, but...
Lynn's probably the purest shooter Brighton has on this ball club.
First free throw by Messino is good. Second one's off the mark. Offensive rebound by number 42, Tom Schleich. And Eastridge leads 7-2. Pass to Cooper. Off-balance shot, it's off the mark. Schleich comes up with another rebound. Mark Vincey brings the foul down court for the Lancers.
I think Brighton needs a timeout right now to settle them down. They're really playing out of control basketball. They really got to get, slow it down a little bit.
Off balance shot by Tomey hits it. It's now 9-2. Eastridge leading the Brighton Barons.
Lance Mepham should call a timeout at this point of the game. They're really playing out of control.
Shot by Albert, and then he's fouled on the play.
So far, Brighton's inside men are being dominated by Eastridge inside men.
Beach, they just look really sloppy. It looks like they didn't come to play so far.
Yeah, well, Joey.
Albert's at the line, shooting two. 78% free throw shooter. First one is good. Makes the score 9-3, Eastridge. And he's got another one coming. This man hit an incredible 16 of 16 free throws against Irondequoit in an early season victory. It's missed, though.
Nice steal by Ronnie A.
Defensive rebound by Neal, but then Ronnie Albert intercepted the outlet pass, and it's Brighton's ball underneath the Eastridge basket.
Ronnie A leads his team in steals and assists.
87 assists for Albert for the season. First on the Brighton Barons. Over to Hamilton. Nomini Robinson's underneath. Lindley up front. Pump fake. Smooth Steve Lindley with a basket that brings Brighton closer to 9-5.
Nice steal by Ronnie A.
Albert with a steal. And the layup and a foul. And a foul on number 12, Mark Vincey. The basket is good.
You're seeing that all-county form now from 44. He came to play tonight, even with that sore arm. Excuse me, John, sore hand.
That's Vincey's first foul. Albert goes to the line to try and complete the three-point play. Now 9-7, Brighton's losing to Eastridge. The free throw attempt is good, making it 9-8, Eastridge.
Great move by Clarence Mepham, having him in a full court man-to-man press.
Some pressure. pressure. Neal off the toe line. This shot, defensive rebound by Cooper. He slows it up.
Brighton's going to try to slow it down now a little bit, John. Try to get a good shot. They've been running pretty well, but still they're a little sloppy. I think they're a little tight in the first quarter.
Shot by Hamilton. It's off the mark. Rebound, minus one, number 42, Tom Schleck. Long pass.
Oh, that was pretty.
Beautiful pass by number 10, Mike Mussino.
A Larry Bird pass, John. That was pretty.
Super pass. Partition off to Hamilton. Pump fake. And he misses again. Rebound by Neal. He goes all the way down course. Passes off to number 10, Mike Mussino. His layup is off the mark. Shot by number 32, Eugene Neal.
I think Mike Davis should be in the ballgame about now. He has to stop Neal. They need somebody big and strong to stop Neal.
That makes the score 13-8 in favor of Eastridge and 1:51 left in the first quarter. There's a steal from Ronnie Albert. Vince over to Mussino, and it's good.
Brighton has to call a timeout, John. They have to call a timeout right about now.
15-8, Eastridge.
Starting to get uncontrolled. I don't know why they don't call a timeout.
Eastridge putting on some pressure. Outlet to Steve Lindley, and he goes over to Ron Cooper. Trying to set it up.
We better look for a good shot here.
They need a hoop badly here, Mike.
3 zone for Eastridge. Pass over to Albert. Switch sides, over back to Cooper. And it's gone. Automatic. 2 points. 15-10. Brighton's losing to Eastridge. Cooper's showing the form that gave him 20 points against Benfield.
Eugene Neal just totally dominated.
And I believe that's Pinky Connors coming in the ballgame.
Pinky is subbed in for number 22, Ron Cooper.
He's done a pretty good job this year, John. He's shooting around 41% from the field. He's done a fairly good job for a first-year varsity ball player. Mm-hmm.
Free throw by Neal. Misses.
Here's
Mike Davis enters the game for Steve Lindley, who on that last play picked up his third personal foul.
Here's the big fella I was telling you folks about. He's going to try to out-muscle Neal. Let's see what happens.
That's good. That makes the score 16-10, Eastridge, with 104 left in the first quarter. Little pressure from Eastridge over to Albert. Brings it down court.
Oh, what a pass by Ronnie Yates.
Lovely pass, turning the other direction. Pass off to Jim Pinky Connors, who's got the layup. 16-12, Eastridge.
Brighton trying to doubling up, and they just didn't shoot the gap on that last play, unless they probably could have got a steal.
Side move by number 42, Tom Schleich, makes it 18, long pass, intercepted by Neal. 18-12, Eastridge is leading.
A little late, but it was a good look on Ronnie A's part.
Casino's got the ball, looks to the hoop, passes off to Neal, back to Vincent. We're going to slow it down for one shot. 10 seconds left in the first quarter. Eastridge leading 18-12.
Look for them to go inside here.
There's a shot. Number 12, Vincey, off the mark. Offensive rebound by number 20. It's good at the buzzer. Making the score at the end of the first quarter. First shot is good. Brighton is now in a 1-1 situation with 5 fouls on Eastridge. That makes the score 22-17. With Eastridge out in front. Second one by Albert is good.
Well, Wolfie, Ronnie A hit his average already. Got 11 points already, and we're only in the second quarter.
5:32 left in the second quarter. Eastridge in front, 22-18. They're going to slow it down.
I think Brighton has to be a little more aggressive out there.
He goes to the hoop, and it's stolen by Davis. Outlet to Albert. Ronnie Albert bringing it down court. He goes to the hoop.
Oh, nice pass.
Hamilton. Eastridge ball.
Nice pass by Ronnie A.
Looks like we're going to see some pressure by Brighton on this inbound pass. Outlet. Tomai.
Wolfie, I'm really surprised about Eastridge. They really impressed me out there. I didn't really think they were this good of a ball club, but yet they only lost to Mendon by 5 points. They're probably the number one team in the East. Well, Fairport is now, but they were really impressed with him.
How cool is that? That is Mike Messino, and it goes in underhand. Albert's got some pressure. I'll let the 50 Connors. Over to Foreman. Foreman takes a baseline. Nice goes to the hoop, and it's blocked by Eugene Neal.
Super black there.
I'm Brighton.
Didn't like that call, Wolfie. It looked like it was off ball to me.
No, I think you got it clean, man.
Pinky Connors picks up his first personal. Third team foul for Brighton.
I think Eastridge is handling the Brighton pressure fairly well. The guards seem to, the guards really impress him, especially that Messino kid. Seems weak, but yet he gets the job done.
No unorthodox. Shoot from the waist kind of style, but it's working for him. In the slice.
Oh, that was a deliberate elbow. There should have been a call on that speech.
But he hit a 10-footer.
Looks like an offensive foul on that one. He stuck his elbow right into him.
Shot by Hamilton, and it's good. A quick 10-footer.
If this man gets hot, you better watch out. He's probably the best streak shooter in the County East this year.
Scored 10 points in one quarter against Fairport last week. Cooper enters the game for Brighton.
This is a great move by Coach Clarence Meppam, having him pick up full court. Right now, John, basically, they're not trying to steal the ball. They're just giving a little pressure.
Steal by Albert. Outline pass by Clarence Cooper. He's going to a basket.
What a move, what a move.
Left hand, it is off the mark.
Neal. Neal, the rebound.
Brighton has two kinds of press.
Stolen again by Cooper. Put on the length of the court. Stops for a nice quick jump shot. Missed. Hamilton rebound, and it's good. Taking the score, 26-22, Eastridge.
Well, I said earlier, Eastridge was handling Brighton's pressure good, but now it doesn't look that way. That's about the second turnover in a row for this Lancer team.
Hamilton fouled up the shot by Cooper and put it in for the Brighton. Off-balance shot by Neal. Rebound by Davis. Oh, he lost it. Albert shot it. Oh, a turnover. Little confusion in the backcourt with Mike Davis and Ron Allen.
When Mike gets that rebound, he has to look for his point or his outlet, man. He shouldn't be dribbling the ball like that. Even though he is a fairly good ball handler.
Mike picks Stank Davis in the game for Brighton.
Wolfie, why do they call him Stank? I've been wondering about that for years now.
I think it's something he picked up when in his younger days, before the high school life. There's a turnover by Eastridge.
Do you know anything about that?
I'm not going to touch that, Dan. I don't really know.
I don't blame you. I wouldn't touch it myself.
Brighton's got the ball with a chance to cut the lead to two. They're going to slow it down with 2:49 left in the second quarter. Hamilton. Off to Davis. Cooper. Garnier. Stolen from Pat Hamilton by Eugene Neal.
Pat can't force things out there. He's a great ball player, but he should have brought it back out to Ron.
Can't afford those turnovers. That's what killed him in the first game.
So far, that's why they're down by four. They're just playing pretty sloppy ball out there. They've done a couple nice things out there, but they're not playing like they usually are. Brighton seemed very upset about the way Brighton's playing. I have a fan here kicking
number
the bleachers over here.
Number 25, Andy Bryandahl, has entered the game for Eastridge. There's a foul on Eugene Neal, his second of the game on the offensive rebound. That brings Albert to the line once again for 1-1.
Line is 6-for-7 from the line so far tonight.
1-1, and it's good.
I tell you, Ronnie A is single-handedly keeping Brighton in this ball game so far.
You're right, Dan. Yeah.
That's his 12th point, I believe, Peach, isn't it?
And there's another one.
He's got 12 points now, Dan.
He's got 12 points.
Great performance by Brighton's point guard. Good double-team trap.
Stolen by Foreman. Pass off to Cooper, and they're going to slow it down and try and tie up this ball.
Very nice, very nice. Brighton's playing excellent pressure defense.
No team. Albert over to Hamilton. Cooper. Swings it to the other side to Ronnie Albert. goes to the basket. Pass
good
off
pass.
To Davis.
Do it, Al.
Puts it up Andy Smith. Rebound by Blindall. 1:39 left in the second quarter with Eastridge leading 26-24.
Eastridge has made numerous turnovers, but yet they're winning by two. That seems odd to me.
Well, we hope that Brighton doesn't have a shooting night like they did when they visited Eastridge January 6th in a 59-58 overtime loss when they shot 26 for 76, only a 34% clip. That was a shot by Messino, and it went out of bounds off a Brighton player.
I think the turnovers are going to catch up to Eastridge sooner or later. They're only up by two, but Brighton seems they had a little momentum going.
Shot by Neal. Rebound by Ron Cooper. He breaks it up court. Pass off to Foreman. Plays once again, throw it up.
That's the man you want to have the ball. Brighton will probably go for one shot now. It'd be the logical thing to do.
52 seconds left in the second quarter. Davis over to Cooper. Pass around. Pat Hamilton with the ball.
Look for Ron Elbert to take the last shot here for the half.
Down to 40 seconds in the quarter.
Good point, Pete.
No, good save by Pat Hamilton.
I think they'll get it to Ronnie A. Ronnie A. will try to penetrate and create play. He's great at doing that.
We're down to 30 seconds.
Ronald will take his 40-foot set shot out there.
Inside pass to Foreman. Foreman goes to hoop. Missed.
All glass.
Oh, 17 seconds left in the quarter. I don't know if they should have taken that shot.
I think the light got in Granny's eyes on that last shot.
That was your basic trick, Dan.
You said it, Pete. It's called the window break.
55 seconds left. Messino. Oh, stolen
nice
by Cooper.
By Ron Cooper.
Nice steal by Cooper. Saved Brighton from losing 2 points.
There could have been even a foul on that last play. It looked like Messino reached in on Cooper.
Possibly. And with the end of the first half, it's Brighton 24 and Eastridge 26. We'll be back with the second half in a few moments.
Brighton's leading scorer was Ron Elbert with 12 points, eight foul shots, 8 for 9 from the line. Ron Cooper had 2, Patrick Hamilton had 6, and James Connors had 2. For Eastridge, the leading scorer was Al Messino with 9 points.
Brighton's going to come back and show us what they made of in the second half. Third quarter will be starting in about 50 seconds.
Eastridge is scoring for the first half. Mike Messino with 9 points. Bob Tomeyer with 8 points. Eugene Neal with 5 points. And Tom Schweit with 4 points. That makes the score at halftime 26-24 in Eastridge's favor.
And with the start of the second half for the Eastridge Lancers, out on the floor are number 42, Tom Schleich, number 32, Eugene Neal, number 12, Mark Vincey, number 10, Mike Messino, and number 25,
well, we don't have any
Andy Blindall. And for Brighton, it's Ron Elbert, number 44, Steve Lindley, Frank Foreman, Pat Hamilton, Ron Cooper. Albert with some pressure after Eastridge won the jump off. Oh, a nice deal by Albert.
Wolfie, I think Coach Mepham told Ronnie Cooper to look for his jumper a little more. He only has 2 points, and he's a big offensive threat for this Brighton team.
They're going to need him to score if they're going to win. He's averaging 14.0 points. And that's second on the Barons to Hamilton. Inbound, in pass, go up and down.
A jump ball. He got his hand on it. Good call by the
referee. Good defense by Grant Foreman.
Got his hand in. Be a jump ball between Foreman and Schleich.
What I said earlier about Brighton getting their big men involved in the offense hasn't really happened so far. And I think it could open this ball game up if they try to get the ball down low to the big men.
Ball on Foreman. Reaching in. That's Foreman's first personal foul. First team foul.
Brighton will be in a zone right now. They're in a 2-3. The only time they really play zone defenses this year is when the other team will take the ball out or when they have a lead. They play a 2-3 or a 3-2 zone.
Vincey, over to Schleich. Cino goes to the basket, shoots away, stops the mark. Lindley's got the rebound.
Nice hustle by Smooth Steve. Great pass.
Foreman.
A patented fast fake. That looked like UCLA mold right there. That was very nice.
And that ties it up for Brighton at 26.
Foul trouble so far. So my three, Eastridge has four, and Lindley for Brighton has three.
Vincey with a long range shot. Cooper with the defensive rebound. He takes it up court. Pass off.
They're off to the races again.
Inbound.
Great pass.
Hamilton. And puts the Barons in front.
Eastridge is trying to call a timeout, and they do.
They do. And with a timeout. With 6:15 left in the third quarter, it's Brighton 28 and Eastridge 26.
Wolfie, Brighton's putting out a clinic right now, running that fast break show. I'll tell you.
Little pressure up court for Brighton. Albert guarding Vincey. No pass off to Neal. Neal's with the layup, puts Eastridge, and inside with Brighton.
You got to get help when Neal goes to the hoop. You can't stand and watch. Weak side help has to come over and help out.
Albert setting it up for Brighton.
Eastridge, still in that.
Boom! Ronnie Cooper.
And that's what Coach Meppham wants Coop to do.
Nicknamed the Frog by his teammates.
You live and die by the jump shot, as Dan always said.
Yes, you do, Mike. But you got to have Ronnie Cooper shooting more than he did that first half. It could be the big difference in this ballgame.
Coop's high games are 20 points against East and 20 points against Penfield. Last time he played Eastridge, he had 12 points and 6 rebounds.
Nice pass.
Oh, Neal lost the handle. Good play by Neal.
I thought Neal's foot hit the line before he made a nice effort and saved it, but it's still Eastridge's fault.
Knocking it off. Brighton's player, Ron Albert.
Nice defense.
Nice quickness.
This team is so quick, Wolfie. It's unbelievable.
Albert's going to the hoop.
Oh!
A little bit too much. He forced that pass. With 5 minutes left in the third quarter, it's Brighton 30 and Eastridge 28.
Ranier is going to make a couple passes like that, but it's his job to create play as a point, and he does a great job at doing it.
Neal again to the hoop with his second straight basket. Ties it up for Eastridge.
Neal keeping Eastridge in this ballgame.
Nice pass from Foreman to Pat Hamilton.